Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of Co-op Mutation King. This week, we will be using some voice comms with our partner. We're playing with Graham Rogers, aka Rifkin from Base Trade TV. Once again, Base Trade TV, the base god themselves, one himself, just Rifkin, Zombie Grub, and Fear Dragon, and Tempo aren't all here to all play co-op at once. It's not possible yet. The technology is not here. But this week's mutation is going to be very interesting. Enemy units can transform into more powerful units whenever they deal damage. Hybrids literally blow up into nukes instantly when they die. And all enemy units spawn broodlings upon death. So this one's going to be tough. And I'm going to bring Graham in now. Let's do it. Let's get this mutation underway. Yo, yo.
Hey, I'm all done. Are you here?
Yeah.
Cool. I got my thing paused. Are you ready?
Yeah, let's go, man. Let's do this.
All right. Awkward pause, unpause. Now I'm here with Nate. What's up, Nate? How you doing?
I'm great, Graham. Life is amazing. And this mutation looks really hard.
It does. I was going to talk normally about what commanders I think are good or not. I'd like to get your 2 cents on a couple of these guys, if you don't mind.
Sure. I thought this was tricky because we were talking about this. Like I was thinking that the normal Karak strategy is probably really bad for this mutation because the hybrid like would get to a Karak's cannon wall even if the cannon wall could kill it.
Wouldn't be able to move them and they'd probably die.
Yeah, because I'm a guy that likes to play mass cannon with Karak. That's like half my mutations. I'm just like, yep, I just solve it by building infinite cannons because I like to make pretty sim cities and whatnot, but. I also think that a lot of other melee characters would also be really, really bad in this. Like,
well, I would give the exception to Zagara, right? Because it doesn't really matter if her units die. Is the reason I pick her sometimes, right? Because you're like, oh, I lost a bunch of Balings, no big deal, because I killed everything in the process.
That's fair. But I'd still be concerned about it, though, because if you have anything else, by the time you kill the hybrid, it should kill all of your other units. Because Amon's nukes don't do friendly fire damage either, so you kind of have to clear the whole wave. But
okay, I was kind of hoping they would, so you just like focus fire it down, kabloom, like everything
would die around it. Well, when they did the random nukes dropping, that one didn't actually kill their own units either when they had an Vermilion problem. So I'm expecting the nukes not to hurt their own units, which is going to make things even more difficult than it already was.
Well, I think my backup. In case any of the commanders we don't pick right away works, I think I'll go with Artanis as my secondary here. I think he's probably going to be one of the better commanders due to his passive. I'm just imagining, okay, the nuke hits, your whole army survives because, woo, he saved them all.
That's true. The Tempest shouldn't be too close to wherever the nukes are as well. And I guess with the higher hit point pool, they can kind of survive it better.
And actually, thinking on that point, too, you take something like Reavers as well, add one or two into the mix, it's just like Zagara having a bunch of Balings launching out.
Yeah.
I think our Artanis should be pretty good. I imagine a lot of people are going to pick him for this, so I'm going to try to not do him right away.
Yeah, what I want to try for my first one is I want to see if I can neutralize, because I know most units lose whatever buffs they have, but if units turn into new units, as someone who likes to mind control, I think I see a scenario here where if the units are starting to get close to leveling up into hybrids, because apparently they can turn into hybrids as well, then I can just mind control the highest tier units, and there should be more high tier units, which should make mind control even better.
Nate, I'm glad we're thinking on these same lines. I'm picking Karak this time around. You said cannons would be bad. We talked a little bit about this beforehand. My thoughts are, though, I took the combat unit reduction cost for his talents, and I'm going to be trying to get out a lot of those sentries that can do the mind control stuff, because if each of these units is transforming, we're going to see immortals, we're going to see tanks, we're going to see a lot of mechanical units I could just steal. And that's worked out really well in some of the past mutations, some of the tougher ones. So I'm hoping it'll apply well
here. As long as it's not a Zerg opponent, then we should be fine.
Yeah, well, then if it's a Zerg opponent, I'm hoping Colossus will carry my ass.
Fair enough.
Pray for that one.
The laser beam Colossi are really, really good.
Yeah. Well, this mutation is going to be taking place on Missed Opportunities. It's the brand new map.
That's the Smoke Terrazine map.
It's the Egon Stepman is crazy. I want to actually cosplay as him crazy for like BlizzCon map. And I think the nice thing about this is the spawn locations are pretty set, if I recall. There's one in like the middle left, two in the top right. Like it should be pretty easy to predict around where those units spawn at least.
Yeah, this map isn't super complicated. The hardest part is just going to be making sure. Actually, now that I think about it, it's going to be really hard. You want to bait the hybrid away from the harvesters, right? Oh, even God. Even if you kill all of them and don't lose your army, if die near the objective.
Yeah. Well, I
just started thinking about this.
So here's the thing. I'm wondering, like, if this is a regular nuke, then I actually think, because they give them like an extra strong defense matrix, maybe they can take a hit. I'm not saying let's chance it, but I'm hoping.
Yeah, I'm not entirely sure myself. This is gonna. I haven't played this at all yet, so.
This is
your first time as well in this mutation.
I think we both woke up and said, "Let's do some co-op."
Yeah, that was the gist today. Stepman his wonderful beard.
Dude, right? I'm pretty jealous of that
beard guy. He didn't strike me as a beard guy in the Wings of Liberty campaign.
No, you know, he struck me as like he looked like Xenocider, I thought, in the Wings of Liberty campaign.
I mean, I was just like regular, ordinary panel nerd, but I'll take that too. Man, I have to say, I still like playing Vorzon quite a bit, but I have to say the nerfs with the rocks and the natural gas has been really triggering.
Yeah, the natural gas rocks are also annoying too, because if you play Alarak and overcharge his pylon to kill the rocks, they'll target the gas over
this happened. Oh my god, the first time I ever played Alarak, I was just like, I put the two pylons there, I'm like, oh yeah, two pylons should be enough to kill rocks, and then it shoots the gas rock, I'm like, no, I can't expand. That was really frustrating.
Yeah. Very, very trigger-inducing. I'm with you on this one. I know last time we played, we didn't have voiceover, by the way, so it's hard to coordinate chrono boost. I'll try and do that better this time we play.
Yeah. I'll let you... We can time out for the mega chronos that you're going to get.
Yeah.
That seems good. I like to use my dark pylons a lot, since you can't use Shadow Guard anymore at the start of the game.
Feels bad, man.
I was one of those people that probably ended up getting it ruined. It's funny because everything abusive I can think of in co-op has been slowly getting patched out. Like, I used to do the build like 8 command centers, and my Raynor strategies, because mules, when you had a double mule perk, it was so broken.
Yeah,
my teammate, I'm like, yo, you take every base, I'll even give you my main and just have my command centers next to yours. And I dropped so many mules, like I still have more income than you because we're both mining off all 4 bases.
He was literally the only race that could mine out one of the actual bases.
It's the only way you could actually mine the map out. Now I have to build like 12 orbital commands to get a similar effect.
I should be able to handle this first wave with orbital strike, by the way. I got lots of energy.
Seems good. I'm not going to be able to expand just yet, so I'll give you my chrono because I don't need probes as much.
Oh, cool. Thank you. A team play, though.
Yeah, man. I love chrono boosting my Terran teammates. I love chrono boosting their command centers because I always think about how slow SCVs build. Now they all turn into Broodlings. It's really annoying. That Zergling turned into a Reaper and the other one a Hellion, now a Zealot.
Okay. Did not know the Broodlings would turn into units. Now I know.
Yeah, that's weird. Okay.
Oh shit, there's still a unit.
Oh my god, it's a Zealot!
I didn't realize.
And then the Zealot turns into Broodlings!
Oh my god, this is gonna be a problem. This is gonna be a problem, I can tell you right now, Nate.
The first bot's about to move out. Oh my goodness. Well, I can use Shadow Guard.
You're gonna have to. I used all my energy. I didn't think I'd have to use all my energy on that.
Alright.
Oh god.
I have to kill them fast before they transform. I heard that they transform when they attack.
On attack, I guess. That's what it looked like with the Zealot and stuff, because nothing was attacking them.
Yeah.
Jeez, this is gonna be a lot rougher than I thought it would be. I didn't want to fly.
I have time stop, but. Alright, just don't let the Lings attack and they won't transform. Well, thankfully, the Shadow Guard is a really good way to deal with the first wave.
Yeah, apparently.
I have the extra duration on them, so makes them a little.
Yo, I'm afraid I'll kill this Overseer and it's going to transform into something. Oh, God. Dragoon!
This is ridiculous. This is one of those situations where they can get units from any race as well.
Yeah, so, well, that's a little bit what I'm banking on, too. It's taking longer than I was hoping to get there, but I want to be able to mind control them when they turn into the Protoss or the Terra Mechanical Unit stuff.
I have to try to get my expansion up. I'm going to try to get some Zealots on there. If you need me to warp in anything over there, just let me know. I'll throw what I can. I need my money.
I need Egon to step in to calm down. Quit sending his bots out so quick.
Yeah, he's actually moving extremely fast. So one of the other things, though, I do have I'm gonna be using my. Oh, I have the dark coil. I got the dark coil for the zealots, so I'm gonna be playing like charge lot dark archon. So the stun should help. Just the second of them not being able to attack should make it a little bit easier. The next two going out already. Yeah.
I wonder if the what's it called, the thing that makes them frenzy and attack each other, if that would trigger it.
Yeah, I'm wondering if male or confusion.
You ready for Corona, by the way?
That.
I really just want to pump probes.
Yeah, I'm just gonna build probes. Go for it.
I am activating chrono boost now. That should greatly
increase. It's like max out my natural.
Alright. My shadow guard should be available for the next push, not this one. I'm gonna put the dark pylon between the Terrazine geysers so that we can use both.
I've got purifier beam for if this gets really out of hand.
Seems good to me.
Yeah, I'll try and get some cannons up there too. Concern is north side. I don't have a good way to clear that out.
Right. Well, just the extra damage from the cannon should help. If any units turn into something really good, I'm just gonna mind control it. Oh, wow, that's a lot. All right, let me try this. Let me try confusing it. Yeah, they doesn't really seem to do a whole lot. Is Cyclone microing against me? Turn into a Ravager. I wanted the Cyclone. I wanted the Cyclone. I got a Ravager. Oh, well.
Oh, God.
All right, freezing it. What is we got? I'll take the Hellbat. Sure. That should be useful. Oh, no, I should have taken the Reaver.
I'm trying to get that tech going. I didn't think I'd have to invest in cannons this early. Sorry.
I got you. The way I play is very slow ramp, but I have a Reaver now, so I got that going for me.
Oh, purifier beaming this.
Oh my god.
Oh, thank god for the purifier beam.
Dude.
Even then, it might not be enough!
Liberator! Oh my god, it turned into a hybrid. It's Ogre. My Reaver's dead. This is disgusting.
I just, there's no way for me to get damage out. I thought I would have so much more time. I still don't even have
much. Yeah, this starts so fast.
Okay, well, we can, shit. If those get to our base, it's gonna really suck. I don't think we can stop it.
It's gonna detonate, isn't it? Well, I could try.
Shadow Guard, maybe, yeah. Okay.
But it's gonna detonate. Oh my god! Okay, wow.
Where's the stun thing? There we go. Chance to stun units, maybe. Oh god, my natural. Oh lord.
Not that's getting my natural gas that fast really hurts.
Oh, I just got Widow Mine.
Yep.
Feels ladder, man.
Feels ladder, man. It's a Tempest. Congratulations. Congratulations, it's a girl.
Oh, no.
The fact that these units can then turn.
I can't build more cannons. My fucking Forge died. Okay, we're definitely not getting the bonus. I think that's safe to assume.
No. I don't see how we beat any of the big waves.
I just have a battle supply block that killed me. Okay, well, I should have mind control this time around, so I've got at least that much going for me.
Alright. Yeah. The Zerg part makes it a bit tricky, but they turn into Terran units. And Protoss mechanical units, so not too much of a problem. I'm finally getting my full gas saturation.
We gotta get north already. Chrono boosting, by the way.
All right. It's not a very upgrade heavy style. All right.
So keep an eye out for mechanical units like that. Scout, yeah, baby.
Rip bot. Whoa, this Marauder has Magrel ammunition.
Oh shit, oh shit. Yo, bot. Dumbass bot.
This is so insanely difficult.
Oh, I might control the time stop unit, it doesn't untime stop it.
Nope. Well, I learned that one the hard way a long time ago.
Oh no! Oh no! Oh shit!
It's Ogre. Is the bot still alive? Nope, it's gonna die. This mutation.
Yeah, I thought this was gonna work with mind control. This is not. I can't play clever bitch on this one.
Yeah, I don't think doing anything fancy is gonna work here. This is gonna be like some Rainer Artanis level stuff. I don't even know, man.
Yeah, I'm gonna play Artanis, I think. You wanna just quit?
These are some legacy of the Void Beta Cyclones too. Those things have like 200 health. They're the unkillable Cyclones.
I'm fairly convinced that I could beat that with Carex, but I don't want to waste a bunch of time doing it right now.
I feel like if we made another attempt with that, maybe we could do it, but it's a bit.
I definitely was overwhelmed with how quickly that came.
Yes, I was extremely caught off guard by that. That was rough.
I wish there was a way we could feed Stepman some like Vespine gas to delay his Terrazine addiction. It's like, yo, send the bots out like 5 seconds.
Just give you like a light hit, then you don't have to, you know, go quite as fast. Give us a little more time to build our army.
Here's 500 gas. Give us 5 seconds. Thank you.
If only I could have taken the gas. That natural block on Vorzon really does hurt the ramp up. I just did not think it would be happening that fast.
All right. I've noticed that every mutation that I classify as like a difficult one is one where free units come out of nowhere. And this definitely falls into that category.
Yep. You know, it's not surprising that people got most triggered in 1v1 by free units. And now we're getting triggered by free units.
Are we getting swarm hosted? Is that what's happening now?
We're getting swarm hosted by broodlings. Would you mind
keeping an eye on them for me? Son of a gun.
That's what it's like, man.
Yo, I had a really great time when we met the people from co-op, but maybe those memories have been forever ruined now. Blizzard co-op!
You know, I remember the part when we were meeting them and one guy was like, yeah, we tried some funny stuff that we didn't think would work in the live game that'll probably never make it into the actual co-op.
Right?
Like, having your camera flip around upside down, you know. And I was I was like, thank God you guys didn't put that in. And then last week happened.
Dude, they does the exact same line. They're like, yeah, the Vertigo thing we're afraid to make too many people sick. There's just absolutely 0% chance that ever goes live, sadly. But would you guys like to try it anyways? I'm like, okay. But the second I saw that as mutation for that week, I was like, oh, everybody's going to be so mad. Like, there's just no way.
That was a pretty brutal one. I had a hard time even just building cannons as Karax. I got pretty lucky. I had a teammate who had a much better sense of direction than me, who just played Mass Tempest, and that made it a lot easier.
Nice.
Have you played Chain of Ascension with Alarak yet, by the way?
No, but I've heard he's got some unique voice lines, which I'm pretty stoked about.
It's awesome. The very first line already changes from Jannara. Like,
I heard she's like brown nosing on him or something.
Yeah. She's the first thing she says, she's like, ah, hi, Lord Alarak. How convenient that you're randomly here or something like that. And she's like, I won't challenge you to Rakshir if you help me. Like trying to make, it's like some weird co-op roleplay.
I won't challenge you to Rakshir, dear High Lord.
Not today.
Don't worry, bro.
It's like Ascension experiment gone wrong.
Pretty much.
I wonder what type of we go against, because I could play. I love playing. I think Mass Vulture is actually broken. If you play against a ground AR army, there's like nothing they can really do against.
Oh god. This is one of those ones where Karex would have been not bad, by the way.
Yeah, Karex would have been good against this. Yeah, this is definitely going to be mech.
One of the problems, or not problems, one of the good things was last time I did that, it was on a train mission where there was nukes flying everywhere. And those nukes didn't affect the spider mines, so I wonder if the hybrids will.
Oh, that's a really good point. I think if I spread the mines out, maybe it won't be as big of a deal, but that's a very important thing to keep in mind.
I'm gonna take your rocks down before coming to the thing.
Okay. Well, that's probably what I should do. I think killing these units might just cause them to transform.
Yeah, you're just making broodlings on us, bro. Feels bad, man. Alright, I got your rocks. Coming on over.
Oh, the splash from those actually helps. Oh yeah, they're right there. Rip. Alright. I'm on my way, senpai.
Wait, what's hurting the marines?
What?
The bot has an attack. I didn't even realize. It's just really weak.
The bot has a really, really weak attack.
Oh, God. Why is your base under attack? You got like a hellbat over here.
There is a hellbat. I'm waiting for it to turn into a broodlord.
Right? I mean, that'd be par for the course. Alright, I'm aiming for Tempest first. I'll get Reavers a little bit later.
That is so hard. They do not give you any time to get ready for this. I'm going to bring my Marines back, and I will use my Hyperion if needed.
You know what? I'm not going to sacrifice any more units. That thing won't die.
That's a good point. There's no need. Good men don't need to die for that bot.
Such a baby set, man.
He really cares for those bots, you know?
Yeah. Oh shit, that became a siege tank already.
What? That Viking?
Yeah. This luckily, game. Siege tanks attack slow as fuck, so okay, that kind of works.
Works for me. Alright. Yeah. I have all my mastery points on the cooldown for Raynor's Hyperion.
Nice.
So I'm gonna spam it pretty hard.
I don't have gas for the Tempest yet. Working on it.
Resource trading would be pretty dope.
Yes, it absolutely
but
would.
Then you would just let Vorazon take all your gas.
Yeah, dude. Hell yeah.
I can't think of a single reason why that might be a bad idea.
Yo, thoughts here. Maybe Phoenix wouldn't be bad. Graviton Beam?
And neutralize some of those other units?
Yeah.
It's nice that the DPS of the Marine allows me to just kill most everything that they throw at me before it's too much of an issue. Although I wouldn't mind playing my troll mind control style. It's the best.
I really like playing mind control anything, so.
Yeah, my control is the best, mate.
Oh my god.
Ghost.
Freaking warhounds. Get out of here.
The higher tech units, since they can turn into the hybrid, should always be.
I guess, yeah, we gotta focus them.
Yeah. I think, I don't know.
Although apparently a warhound turns into a siege tank. I thought a warhound would be above a siege tank, to
warhounds,
be honest.
Warhounds should be above hybrids. It should be that the hybrids can turn into warhounds, honestly.
Oh, I forgot your medics can heal my zealots. I shouldn't be throwing away like this.
Easy.
I need to get some charge.
Oh! Oh. Hybrid rip.
Back away from it.
Oh my god.
Oh shit, why's my base under attack? Where did these brood legs come from? I just hate that.
Well, thank god for your shield.
Dude, brood
legs turns into a liberator.
Brood legs turning into units is pretty ridiculous. That's like a little over the top for this.
The fact that the free units that spawn can also turn into those units is really triggering me.
Oh, I can graviton two enemies at once with upgrade. I forgot about that.
Didn't Raynor's battlecruisers get buffed recently?
The ones he built? Yeah.
I think they're still garbage, though, right? Yeah, they're still pretty bad.
Generally?
It seems to me that there seems to be a misunderstanding on why battlecruisers are bad units. And it's got very little to do with their mobility or hit point count, Blizzard. They don't do damage.
Oh, shit, you're shielding. Oh, jeez, come in.
No, go away. Actually,
oh,
the Reaver was more of a threat.
Oh.
Oh wow, it's a mini. It's a mini nuke. The small hybrids blow up in a mini nuke.
I like that it gives you like a half of a second to walk away.
Yeah.
How generous.
It gives you just enough time to be like, oh shit, I'm gonna lose my.
Oh, speaking of which.
Oh my god. So I hope you didn't need lost a lot of digital ones and zeros over there.
It's an understatement.
All my ones and zeros, they're gone. I
Oh, thank you for the repairs.
Oh, they're on auto repair, man.
Well, thank you. Not the best.
I'm not even thinking about helping you right now.
I'm wow.
I'm
wow.
riding a struggle bus. I'm on the one-way express to Pain Train Town. I feel when you're playing Rainer and you're broke.
Yeah, I was hoping to get Reavers mixed in with this, but man, I got no gas.
Yep. I think if I could, if we could stabilize, I wouldn't mind giving you my base.
Nah, it's I think you'll need as much as I will at this rate. But yo, the being able to lift up the whole army with these Phoenix is real nice, I gotta say.
I don't think they can, yeah, they only transform when they're attacking, so.
Yeah.
This is still triggering for me because siege tanks are really good versus
I don't
Rainer.
Think we can save the other bot. Oh shit. Okay, we can't make any more mistakes. Oh, you're in there. Put defense drone.
I'm trying.
Oh, the fucking bunkers. I can't lift anything up.
Wow. Okay.
The other one needs to save.
I lost it all. Nothing lasts forever. Oh, no.
Oh, recovery from this is going to be rough. Oh, these nukes are nasty, too. I don't got any big cooldowns.
Dude, Rainer is just garbage versus Mech Amon. I'm not going to lie. Like, siege tanks are so unbelievably strong.
Oh my god, that thing turned into a hybrid like immediately!
Oh my god.
Solar bombarding this group. And then what is this? This hybrid! Oh no. I was wondering where'd all my stuff go? Back at home! There's a friggin' hybrid! Killing my base!
Oh my god.
I was like, I can't warp anything in. What's happening?
If we had gotten the same comp as last game, I think what we're doing right now would have been perfect.
Oh my gosh.
We got screwed by the RNG.
You know what?
Rainer's trash versus tanks.
I'm a little bit pissed, but I'm also glad that this is difficult because it means it won't be like beat it once and then do nothing all week.
No. This one's going to be fun to do a lot of times, I think.
Oh, yeah, this is over. Unfortunately, I don't know if I got time for another. So,
all right,
we should definitely come back for some revenge, I think.
I think so. Amon's been cheating this game, but I don't think we can beat him right now.
So I do want to put like one footnote that I think is going to be important, and I'm going to try and mentally remember this for later. One cannon in the base to kill broodlings, and I'm pretty sure this one hybrid in my base was not a hybrid that walked in. I think it was a broodling that just slowly
became he started in the mail room. He worked his way up.
Oh my god!
His dues.
It became a Loki!
And it became,
then it became a hybrid! What the fuck? Blizzard!
I think the Loki is scarier than the hybrid, personally. But
yes, agreed.
How did a Warhound just turn into a ghost? What?
Yeah. I want to see what that ghost becomes, if anything.
I think Blizzard underestimates how good the Warhound was.
Ghost into a Liberator, no big deal.
Just watching the chain of ascension, right?
Wait, why did the Liberator die? You don't have anything that can kill it, neither do I.
This is interesting. All right.
It's kind of fun watching the destruction. You have some shields.
GG.
GG.
What an interesting mutation.
I'm excited to play more, and I genuinely mean that.
Yeah,
so.
This is going to be a fun challenge, I think, for the time being. What an insanely difficult mutation that they've cooked up this week. Good God.
It's going to be fun. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure to visit Nate's channel if you're watching on my channel. And
maybe visit mine if you're watching
on
Nate's
channel. And make sure you visit Base Trade's channel. You're putting this on the normal Base Trade TV YouTube?
Yeah. I'm awesome. Just putting it on Base Trade TV. So we should be back, hopefully, and beat this mutation later, guys. But thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, all that YouTube-y stuff. I'll see you later.
Cheers, mate.